Hello guys and welcome back to the channel. Today we're gonna be discussing about crypto Bitcoin, but more importantly I would like to discuss to give you a price prediction on how to navigate this new merging news of the three most important AI coins, which is AGIX, Fetch.ai and also Ocean AI coin. Before, of course, we continue, don't forget to subscribe to the channel for more updates about this crazy cryptocurrency market. Now, let's talk about Bitcoin, guys, straight away, and then we're going to talk about the merger to give you a little bit of price prediction and what we can do to trade that. So Bitcoin at the moment, guys, yesterday we had a beautiful pump, and I was saying that if we were able to break $69,200, we would have just gone and continued to the upside. And of course, guys, our VIP members have made incredible gains based on that prediction. As you can see, guys, crazy amount of green over here. So of course, if you want to join the VIP group, link in the description below. But let's go back into this, and we can see Bitcoin on the daily chart straight away, guys. So we had a pump at roughly $70,300, and then we had a bit like a big retracement. And the question people asking is right now, you know, what is going to be happening from here? Guys, we have a very important event coming up, which is going to be the European Central Bank and also the Bank of Canada. And they're going to decide whether they're going to cut interest rates, and it's going to be tomorrow and also on Thursday. So if that is going to happen, if they're going to have they're going to cut interest rates, I could really see Bitcoin to continue to go to the upside. It's going to be a very important bullish catalyst, which could really help to pump the price to new highs. At the moment, guys, on the daily chart, you can see that Bitcoin is still had a beautiful break to the upside. It's still stuck in this area and it hasn't moved a lot. Even yesterday, like, you know, with this big explosion, we're still like in a sort of a what we can call like a bull flag. And the question, of course, you know, everybody's asking is when are we going to go and explode and break this flag over here. So what I think is going to be happening right now, right, tomorrow and also Thursday are going to be very important to understand if we're going to go back down over here. So if you're gonna go and have a drop again around this area over here, or are we gonna continue to the upside? So in my opinion, that's what I think it could be happening right now. So based on what is going to be happening with this the European Central Bank and the Bank of Canada, I could be seeing in the worst case scenario right now, in a, of course, short-term point of view, a drop of Bitcoin, maybe going down around this box over here, one last drop to 66,300, and then finally a big break to the upside from here. But otherwise, guys, yesterday break was actually quite remarkable. We can see that even if you are going to go on to like a lower time frame, you can see on the 4-hour chart, right, we had actually like a proper breakout from here. So we had a breakout, and right now we are just retesting this breakout from here. You can see like very similar to on the other time frame, and looking at the chart from here, guys, looks like, you know, we had a big pump from here, and then we had the consolidation from here, retesting the breakouts, and now we should be able, if you know things go well, we should be able to continue to go to the upside. And if you're going to be able to break this structure over here, the next target is going to be roughly at 71,500. So it is going to happen, 71,100, maybe up to, let's say, you know, today and tomorrow, and then bit of a drop again because of the news of the European Central Bank. And then if they're going to decide to cut interest rates, then I can see Bitcoin moving to, of course, all-time high. And of course, guys, we give this prediction of a drop to 68,500 in our VIP group. You can see on Bitcoin updates, you could have dumped around 60,500, and we just give all of this in advance, and this is what has happened. So at the moment, that's what I'm looking for Bitcoin. We can also have a look a little bit, guys, something I was saying before about the DXY yesterday. The dollar currency index looks like is into a downtrend, which of course is putting more fuel for Bitcoin to continue to the upside. And I think this is going to continue. I can see the DXY to continue a downward path in this area over here, roughly $103 to $102. And if this happens, of course, it's going to be very bullish for Bitcoin and also for stocks and risk assets. So very positive as well with this. So what I can see from here could be, of course, sort of like a bear. We had a bear flag from here, break of the bear flag, maybe continuation down to here. And after that, we're going to see how what's going to be happening on June 12th. Guys. June 12th is going to be very important CPI report and FOMC meeting, because if the CPI is going to come higher than expected, then we're going to be in trouble and the DXY could shoot up again to the upside. But otherwise, if it's going to go lower than expected, the Fed is going to cut interest rates, we could be seeing this falling even more to the downside. So of course we take everything level by level, but that's what I can see with the DXY. So the DXY is going to continue to go to the downside, at least around this area over here. I can also highlight to you again, so I'm going to get a line here, I'll bring it here. So this is the area that I'm actually looking for. Again, bear flag from here, taking from here, and it brings me to roughly this area at 102. So by 10th or 11th of June, so in a week time. So I think that's it, guys, for Bitcoin and the stock market. And now let's talk about the merger. So as you already know, Fetch.ai, AGIX, and also Ocean are going to merge into a new company called ASI, which is going to be the leader of the AI coins. And everybody's asking right now what is going to be happening if FET or Ocean is going to drop to the downside, is going to drop even more. And guys, from a fundamental point of view, it's very difficult to say if we're going to drop, if the price is going to stay the same, or if we're going to pump, because unfortunately we don't know. But there is something that's from a strategy point of view I could think of. So the merge is going to be around June the 11th, and the thing is, Bitcoin has a very high chance that it's going to pump at least to $73,000-$74,000, especially if tomorrow and also Thursday the ECB and the Bank of Canada are going to cut interest rates. So if that is the case, then I can see, of course, coins like Fetch.ai, Ocean, all that to pump along with Bitcoin. So what I could be see from here, let's say we're going to be see from Fetch.ai, okay? So that's the chart I'm looking at the moment, guys. We could be seeing maybe Fetch, if Bitcoin, of course, you know, is going to pump, we could be seeing something like this. Maybe from this level over here, we're going to see a continuation up to here. And this is what could be happening is that this movement, okay, is going to come, this upward momentum is going to come in anticipation of the merge, of the AI merge, and it's going to continue until the merge is going to be on June 13. So it's going to be at the same time as the CPI report. So we need to see if market makers are going to front run this event and are going to push Fetch price to maybe $2.80, $2.90. So guys, if this is the case, that we're going to see Bitcoin pumping like crazy, and then FET is going to, of course, to follow. And then we know that during the merge, we might see another drop to the downside, because it could be dangerous. What we can do would be to, of course, front run all of this, and then sell maybe 70%, 60% of our bags when the time comes of the merge, which is going to be on June 12 or 13. And this, guys, of course, is not financial advice, but I'm just giving you what I think I would do and what I'm actually going to do. So looking at Fetch.ai, guys, because whenever they're going to do the merge, the price is going to be in relation to FET. That's why I'm utilizing the FET chart as a reference point. You know, the FET chart at the moment, guys, it's into an interesting situation. So we are pretty much holding up, you know, on this level over here. But if I had to have a look at how low we could go to, what I could think of would be one level around this area over here, so around the $2.10. Another level would be down to here, maybe around $1.60. And the other level is going to be maybe around the $1.20, $1.30. So let's say in case, you know, you want to decide that Fetch.ai is for you, and you think, you know, the the project has, like, you know, very good potential long term from now until the alt season. That could be the buy levels I will be interested in. Like you say, for example, I want to buy and hold for the next 6 to 12 months, then I could think of maybe buying 30% over here, 33% over here, 33% over here, because then what I'm going to do, I'm going to dilute the price around this area, and then once Fetch is going to be ready, then I could be seeing. So I'm going to go and show you. Let me just cancel all of that. But if I'm going to be seeing, let's say, ASI, you know, Fetch, I'm going to go like that. Let's say it's going to go down, you know, around this area over here, which definitely could be happening, but it's going to go around this box area, guys. Eventually you're going to be seeing an explosion coming. So we could be dilute the price, you know, we could buy a little bit lower around this area over here, and then if it's going to go here, then eventually it's going to again break this pennant over here, and then what we could be seeing could be something like this. Could be upper movement, consolidation, and then explosion to the upside with a target of roughly $5.80 to $5. That could be definitely a possibility for a Fetch, because as you know, guys, I'm very well known not to be a moon boy. I like to be more of a realist, and that's what I'm going to do to apply perfect risk management. I'd rather buy only 33%, only a third of my desired position around here, and be safe and make money like this, than actually to say to buy 100% here with the risk we're going to go down another 40%. But that's what I will do at the moment. I will look at Bitcoin, what is going to be happening, because of course, guys, if the ECB doesn't cut interest rates as well as the Bank of Canada and Bitcoin drops to 64,000, then I will be very careful to, you know, to think about, you know, longing FET at the moment. But of course, as I showed you before, target levels is going to be around $2, around 160, and around 140. That would be the areas which I would be very interested to buy for, like, long term. We can also see a little bit more like a macro point of view. I'm going to go on the weekly chart. As you can see, Fetch is into, like, a compressive state, and the first level I can think of, which will make me think of course, for a potential drop to the downside, could be roughly around here. I'm gonna go on to my box, so it could be around this area over here, guys. So around maybe 1.5 to 1.4, that could be a good level for Fetch AI to go, because remember that these things can happen, and that could be something like this. Could be a consolidation, compression, dump after the merge, maybe something like this, and then another explosion to the upside. That's what I can see right now for Fetch AI, which could definitely make sense, because if you connect these points over here to these points over here, brings you roughly around here, around $5. So that's what could be seen from here. We can also go and see what is our golden pocket utilizing our Fibonacci retracement. We can see from here, and the 61.8 brings us to 1.43. So I would say the safest point for entry here will be around in between 1.5 to 1.4. And this is my own opinion, guys, not financial advice, as I said before. So that could be, in my opinion, the best entry you can get with Fetch AI. It's going to dip even more, maybe, who knows, but that could be, I think, an area with a very good risk to reward to have, like, another pump coming for the next 6 to 12 months. We can also analyze more intraday what's happening right now. So I'm going to go on the 1 hour chart. I mean, guys, the chart looks pretty much, you know, going into a downtrend, but at the moment you can start to see a little bit of a formation of what we call a bullish divergence, you know, over here, already forming a bullish divergence, and it looks like, you know, it could be going a little bit maybe lower, maybe down to this area here, and then perform another bounce to the upside. That could probably be happening. So another bounce from here, and then final explosion to the upside, maybe to 220 to 230. But of course, you know, still very early to say this. All right, guys, I'm going to also have a look at AGIX very, very quickly. Like, it's something that, of course, you know, we can have a look. I'm going to go on the weekly chart to see if there is any difference with Fetch AI. As you can see, like, you know, the charts are very, very similar. So very similar to, as I said before, to Fetch AI. You know, this is the compression area. big support, maybe around the 0.6570. What I could be seeing from here could be another potential flag or pennant. I don't know how you wanna call it, but maybe it could be something like this. Correction to go down, you know, around this area, maybe around the end of June or July, and then from here, big break to the upside, and then continuation, because you could do one, two, and then three. But again, it's going to bring us to this target over here. You're not going to be see this chart over here anymore, because once the merge occurs, then they're going to cancel all of this. But I would say that, in my opinion, from like a long-term perspective, I can really see ASI from the $2 level to reach at least $5 at the end of this bull market, which could be finishing in the next 6 to 10 months. Guys, I really hope this was helpful to give you a better idea what could be happening with this merger. As I said before, the European Central Bank and the Bank of Canada are going to cut interest rates. That could be very positive for crypto. We could see Bitcoin pumping to new all-time high, and of course altcoins are going to follow. So be very careful, because what we could be seeing could be a potential euphoria into the market. People are going to get overconfident, and then on June 12, the Federal Reserve might attend their FOMC meeting, and they probably won't cut interest rates, whereas lots of people will think they will. So be very careful with that, because if they're not going to cut interest rates and people expectation is for a cut, we're going to be in trouble, and we could see another drop to the downside. Guys, thank you so much for watching this video. You have a great day, and otherwise I'm going to see you tomorrow, which I'm going to discuss a very important video about all season.